Hi, I'm Captain Pat with the Kayak Fishing ClassicS. We have a special treat for you today. I'm in the studios of our good friend and sponsor, Steve Whitlock. Steve, thanks for bringing us into your studio. How have you been?
Really busy, Pat. I'm just cranking new paintings out left and right. I'm kind of slowing down on my art show season this year a little bit. So it gives me a couple months to get caught up on work and then a little bit of fishing.
That's nice. I see you've been very busy. Let me step out of frame here. We've shown some of your new work, but this is really incredible stuff, too. It's just absolutely gorgeous. And the Sarasota Bay, that's beautiful. That's one of my favorites. You did that, a few years back?
The artwork on this piece is actually done on an Indian River chart, but because we do so many tournaments in the Sarasota and Tampa Bay market, I'm able to digitally take that artwork and drop it onto any chart I want for tournaments now. And it gives us a really nice footprint, a nice signature in the market area around here as far as doing these, because we can custom tailor the artwork species to the location for the tournament. Tournaments don't want to use the same artwork every year.
Right. Well, that's just absolutely fantastic. And you've got some big shows coming up here that are very important to you. Why don't you tell us about that and share it with everybody?
Yeah, we're leaving tomorrow, as a matter of fact, for Virginia Beach for the Boardwalk Show. It's the 59th annual Virginia Beach Boardwalk Show, and it's very exclusive. There's 300 artists. There's 250,000 people will show up, and it's original show only. There's no reproductions allowed whatsoever.
Wow, impressive.
We leave there, and we go down coast to North Carolina to do a show on the Outer Banks during Wednesday and Thursday, and then we're back here for about a week. And we turn around and drive to Rockport, Texas to do one in Texas. Texas has been very good to us lately.
Wow. That sounds like a very, very busy schedule. Are you going to be doing any fishing or relaxing at all?
Yeah, I hope to do a little bit when I'm in Rockport. I don't know if I'll do any in Virginia or not. When we get back from the Rockport show, I may be doing ICAST. I'm not sure if I'm going yet. We do shirts for Denali, and I may be over with Denali for ICAST. And we turn around and leave ICAST. We go to the Keys. I'm a vendor with Bass Pro Shops, 40-some images online with a dropship program, 6 stores currently selling artwork. So we have to go down and kiss babies and shake hands once in a while. And, of course, it's a paid vacation. I get to go to the Keys for a week, and my Hughes manages to follow me down there with one of my two trucks. So we have a good time while we're down there.
That sounds good. I know the originals can be kind of pricey for average folks like me in the print, and is a little bit different price-wise. Can you tell us about that a little bit?
Sure. We understood from the very beginning that not everyone could afford original painting. And, you know, some of these larger originals, these, for instance, are in the $7,000 to $8,000 range. Mm-hmm. You know, custom commissions in the same range. If a guy wants his sport fish painted on it, I can do it for that price point. Something like this is in the $400 range. It's a reproduction. It's a little bit smaller, and it fits everybody's pocketbook. But we have everything from an 11 by 17 open edition $20 print up to an original painting. So we cover all the bases.
That's nice. So that makes it affordable regardless of who you're appealing to, because I know everybody loves them. It's just how deep is your wallet at times. So that's pretty neat. So I noticed on this painting, we put this one in some of the filming earlier, and we're going to put it into it. That's the new one that you had just finished off recently, right?
Yeah, this piece is Cape Sable to Cape Hatteras, and it features a white marlin, yellowfin tuna, and blue marlin, major species for that part of the country. So you have to really match the hatch when you do chart art. I get busted big time if I paint something wrong, if I mount the wrong lure in the framing. I get called out on it, and it takes an angler to do this type of work. I mean, if you're not a fisherman, you're not a waterman, this isn't going to work for you. It's not your gig.
I see. That makes a lot of sense. On the Sarasota Bay, we just had a Kayak Fishing ClassicS tournament here this week, and a good friend of ours, Eric Henson, really loved this, and he really wanted to win it, and it just so happens that he did.
Yeah.
And so he was really excited. He'll probably be over here chatting at you and asking you more about it. So, well, I think that wraps us up. Do you have anything else that you'd like to add? I noticed that you've been doing some tumblers, too.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, we're doing Turvis tumblers, corporate commissions and tournaments mostly at this point. Hopefully through the summer, we're going to go ahead and start purchasing our own, and we'll put them up on the website. But, you know, they're absolutely beautiful. It features a clear, transparent chart and the artwork laid in on top of it.
Wow.
And Turvis makes the finest product there is anyway. But I'm very happy and very excited about working with Turvis Tumbler on these. They're perfect.
That's absolutely incredible. We're going to have to get some Kayak Fishing ClassicS artwork on there here pretty soon and offer those up as well. Well, that's all that we've got for right now. We got to let Steve get going. His wife's waiting on him. Actually, they're going to pack these pictures up and take off. So thanks for listening. And Steve, thank you again. And we'll see you real soon. Good fishing.